One nice thing about mathematics is that sometimes through collaboration you develop very deep friendships with people, and it's something that I really like a lot. When someone is a bit down, the other one motivates, the team goes up. My wife Michaela and I were married for 1.5 years. She's also a professor of mathematics and she teaches at the University of Durham in the United Kingdom. We try to see each other about once every 10 days. Sometimes I go to Durham, sometimes she comes to Zurich, sometimes we meet in some different place. It is not easy to be apart, and we know that is a consequence of our academic work. I'm a professor at ETH Zurich, and I've been teaching here for the last 2 years. I work in the broad area of partial differential equations. These are equations that I use to describe physical phenomena. Among several problems I worked on, one to which I devoted a lot of my attention is the optimal transport problem. The optimal transport problem consists in finding the cheapest way of transporting a distribution of mass from one place to another. A main focus of my research has been to apply the optimal transport problem to other fields. As an important result in this direction, I managed to use optimal transport to study superimmetric inequalities. There is a famous Greek legend about the formation of Carthage. When Queen Dido arrived in North Africa, she wanted to build a city. And so she asked the local king for a piece of land. The king agreed to give her as much land as she could enclose in a single ox hide. What Dido did was to take the ox hide and cut it into very thin strips that then she sewed together. In order to enclose as much land as possible, she drew a semicircle next to the coast, because in this way, she was maximizing the area enclosed inside this piece of leather. This was the beginning of the foundation of Carthage and of the isoperimetric problem. Although isoperimetric inequalities have been motivated with the legend of Dido, they are much more than that. Isoperimetric inequalities appear in geometry, in physics, and are connected to the shape of soap bubbles and the shape of crystals. For instance, if we want to understand how the shape of a crystal changes when raising the temperature, we need to study an isoperimetric inequality. To do that, I used optimal transport theory. Another important application of optimal transport theory is in meteorology. To model large-scale atmospheric flows, meteorologists use the so-called semi-geostrophic equations. These equations are used to predict the evolution of clouds. If you want to understand how clouds evolve, you may think of them as made of many infinitesimal particles. If you look at clouds at two different instants of time and you want to understand how each particle has moved, you need to solve an optimal transport problem. It is through this connection that we have been able to solve these equations.
One good thing about mathematics for me is that I could do it everywhere. I like just to walk in the city center and look around and see people. It makes me feel alive.
In recent years, I've managed to solve several problems that I wanted to. But still, my to-do list is long, and I have work for the next 30 or 40 years. However, there is one problem that I really hope to solve soon, and this is me and my wife living in the same city.